Students in India, like students, typical IIT guys who work there as for 2 years, and then you've seen people in the US. So, like, what's the difference between them? Like, what kind of mentality do students have abroad, and what kind of mentality do students have in India? I mean, what is the difference between, like, in terms of
Students abroad work a lot less. Students
really?
abroad work a lot less.
I
At least it's at least I've seen so far. International students generally work harder than American
okay.
students, and they learn very little in their undergrad, at least in physics. I'm saying in physics. I don't know any other branch. I don't know any. I know disclaimer, but in physics, the stuff we learn in undergrad is insane.
Wow.
Like I'm doing. I there was a master's like I'm doing master's courses now, and like at least so far, I know all my course stuff. So we
Okay.
have done all of this in undergrad and
Wow. Okay.
more. These
Got it.
people have not done. So a lot of the international students from China have also done this stuff. And they're
Okay.
like, hey, what the fuck? We learned all this in undergrad. What are you guys doing?
Okay.
So at least I feel, yeah. But that's the thing with undergrad in the US. I think they pick up the pace a lot, like in master's and PhD, and they eventually, do well.
Okay.
So there's not much forced learning in undergrad. They go
Okay.
slow, they learn everything properly. So that's also good in a way. That's good. So they do
Perfect.
that, and eventually they really, if you really, really want to learn, there's a lot of stuff to, I mean, anyone in the US can learn very well. So they eventually learn in master's and PhD and eventually do well.
Wow. I mean,
Apart from that,
so
I don't really think there's much of a difference. It's just amount we are put made to learn in undergrad. That's it. We are
okay,
made to
so
learn a lot of math.
damn. So, I mean, in undergrad, you think the pressure is higher for students as compared to the US? As
Oh,
compared.
pressure? I wasn't talking about pressure. I was talking about stuff we learned. Like,
Support.
we learn a lot more. The workload is a lot more. And pressure, though, it's infinitely more, I'd say. I mean, it feels, I mean, definitely. The grading. So, the US, one thing I like about the US is their grading system. They are liberal with grades. They are like, hey, we'll encourage you to learn positive reinforcement. Whereas in
Oh,
India, you have negative reinforcement. They're like, you don't learn, we'll screw you over.
that's actually true. I mean, I do electrical engineering, and we get really, really bad grades if we really screw up. I mean, the average
Exactly.
grade was C minus. Like, I mean, that's
Oh,
how bad
fuck. That's bad.
it.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So you don't have that in the US. People are generous with grades. They're like, we want you to learn. We want you to be happy. Like, really? This is
Wow.
different. Back home, I'm not used to this.
Yes, exactly. We're not used to such that
Exactly.
kindness. Yeah. I mean, yeah.
Exactly. It's so weird. Yeah. But it's good in a way. It's really good. Yeah.
Damn, man. I mean, so I think the opportunities that you have abroad, especially when you go into pure sciences, is much higher as compared to India. Suppose, let's say, a person who's not interested in doing masters at all, but he wants to land a job in quantum computing. What should his point of view look like? What should he do? Or how should he up go up upskilling himself and getting himself ready for the job?
So if you want to get a job in quantum computing without doing master's or PhD, so quantum computing in general has three, you can, there are three ways you can get into quantum computing. So either through physics. So physics is sort of about the hardware, how do you implement quantum computing, et cetera, et cetera. How do you sort of engineer quantum systems? Electrical engineering, which is also sort of how do you engineer quantum systems, how do you control the electrical parts of it, et cetera, et cetera. Or the algorithm side, which is basically how do you run algorithms? How do you design algorithms that are made for quantum computers? So, if you want to get into the algorithm side, there are a lot of sites, online sites available, like IBM Q, IBM Quantum Experience. So, they basically have quantum computers you can use. You have to write code on your laptop and it'll run it on its server. So, it
Okay.
allows you to play with quantum computers in real life. And learn how to code on quantum computers, learn how to run programs on them. And they have contests every year, so you can participate in those and stuff. So there are a lot of opportunities that you can participate in if you're looking to get into the algorithm side. If you're getting into the design side, I would say it's very difficult without a master's or a PhD because you'll have to learn that much. You can do research assistantships, of course. You can, say mail professor and say, hey, I'm interested in working with you for a year, just see where it
Wow.
goes. But eventually, you'll have to gain enough experience as a research assistant and eventually be able to translate that into a physics or electrical job.
Wow.
That will be much harder, I would think.
Yeah, so I think it makes sense to like do a master's and then go there. I mean, otherwise it's like you
At least a
doing an
master's,
RA
I
or
think.
something.
Yeah, otherwise, it's not that easy. because they generally prefer PhD students because, you know, undergrad me you don't really learn specific knowledge. So
So what does a life of PhD student look like? I mean, like, can you just walk us through your day? Like, what do you do? Like, is it just
oh
research, or like this is like
no, it varies a lot. Like, you know, hey, we have social lives, we have like normal, it's like a normal student's life, except like, you know, instead of like learning 24/7, we do a bit of research here. Like, since I'm in my first year, I have my master's courses also, so I do my coursework, I have to do homework, and then if I have time, I have to squeeze in time for research. It becomes difficult. Then of course, if you're in the US, you'll have to cook, you'll have to, you know, do all that stuff, like manage life, manage banking, manage all that stuff. That is difficult. That is a difficult part. I'm actually fine with, like, you know, courses, the banking, cooking. That is harder. That is new for me, so.
Yeah, I mean, that's something that everyone has struggled with. Do we ever know? Tell me how to get a girlfriend in the US. People will be interested to know about this.
Okay. How
No,
to get
just
a
a
girlfriend in the
joke.
United States? I don't
Yeah.
know. Ask people out. I don't know.
Damn. Wow, man. I mean, but then,
Ask
like,
people.
yeah. How come we didn't think of this? Ask people out so easy.
Yeah, for guys, ask people out. For girls,
Say
talk to
yes.
guys. That's it. Talk to guys. That's it.
Yeah,
Hope they ask you
simple.
out.
Yeah, give hints, give
Or you
hints.
can ask guys out. Or you can ask guys out. That's fine
Yes,
too.
we know that. Yeah, hope they know that. Ask the question again because I'll cut that part out. So, like, does what college that you go to does it matter for your master's and your PhD? Because, like, whether you go to an IIT or a BITS or any other top college or some other college is not that well known. How does it matter? And how, let's say, a person who doesn't belong to a really great college in his undergrad, how should he apply for a master's? How should his thought process be like?
So